In the past, NASCAR was simply a race from start to finish, and the champion was the driver who finished well most consistently. Over the past few years, NASCAR has undergone a lot of changes in the individual races and in how points are awarded. That makes things a little more complicated, but don't worry, because we're here to simplify it for you. I'm Alanis King with Jalopnik, and today we're going to explain how you win a NASCAR championship. The highest level of NASCAR, the Cup Series, has a 36-race season. The first 26 races are the regular season, and the last 10 are the playoffs. To win the title, you have to first qualify for the playoffs, and then win the playoffs. To qualify for the playoffs, you have to either win at least one of the regular season races, or get enough points based on how you run throughout the season to get into the playoffs. Points are complicated, but you can score them based on where you place in certain segments of a race and at the end of a race as a whole. So let's say you made it to the playoffs. Great! Now all you have to do to win the championship is get through three rounds of playoff races and win the fourth round. There are three races in each round until you get to the last round where there is only one. But the stakes are higher in the playoffs because fewer racers are allowed to progress to each round, and you're more likely to get eliminated. Here's a breakdown of the playoff rounds and how many racers are in each in the Cup Series. Each round, the four drivers who did not get enough points are eliminated. Round 1 has 16 drivers. Round 2 has 12 drivers. Round 3 has 8 drivers. So now you've made it to round 4, the final round. Round 4 has only 4 drivers, and points no longer matter here. Winner takes all. Now you have won NASCAR's highest title. You are the NASCAR champion. So, as a quick side note, if rounds only have a few drivers competing for each win, why are there always so many cars on the track? Well, even though you might see 40 cars on the track in the last round, only 4 of those racers are actually competing for the overall win. Having the other 36 drivers out there gives the sponsors more view time and gives the racers a chance to test their car for next year. That happens in almost every other motorsport series when a driver falls out of contention in the point standings, so NASCAR isn't alone just because it has an elimination system. But if one of those other 36 cars comes in first, they still get a nice lump of cash and a chance to do celebratory burnouts with the champion. Now it's probably time for you to go celebrate too, because you can now say you understand a complicated new NASCAR. If you need more guidance as the season goes along, we'll be right here to help you out.